Hello and welcome to the YouTube channel Misha Impossible. I am Mikhail Sergeyev, or Professor Misha, as my students call me by my Russian nickname. Before we start, please remember to like this video, subscribe to my channel, and push the little bell button if you enjoy my educational programs and want to receive notifications about upcoming projects. And now, let's begin. Today we will discuss Plato's dialogue, Parmenides. In this dialogue, Parmenides questions the young Socrates about his theory of forms. These questions produce aporia, which is perplexity or literally lacking passage in Socrates, if he gives specific wrong answers. One such question concerns participation. Socrates tells Parmenides that the many F objects participate in the form or the F itself. Parmenides then does to Socrates what Socrates does to his interlocutors in earlier dialogues. He makes him admit that his beliefs are inconsistent. In this video, I will present and explain Parmenides' argument. Parmenides belongs to the middle dialogues of Plato, where the theory of forms, particularly the notion of partaking, becomes the subject of a strong critique. In previous dialogues, Socrates rejected the approaches of natural scientists because they ignored the criteria for the truth or falsity of their judgments about nature. He already pointed out the priority of a search for definitions, or the necessary and sufficient conditions for the application of terms. According to that claim, the real cause of a thing is something that exists as itself and which this thing is partaking of. I quote, "The greater, for example, is greater by and by reason of greatness, and the less is less only by and by reason of smallness," end quote. This concept of partaking is exposed to further critique and clarification in the first part of Parmenides. After a short introduction, the dialogue goes on to the exposition by Socrates of his theory of forms. Having mentioned the central thesis of Zeno about the non-existence of many, Socrates notices its closeness to the claim of Zeno's companion Parmenides concerning the ultimate existence of one. However, Socrates himself holds a different position. He thinks, as Parmenides restates it, that, I quote, "there are certain forms of which all other things partake, and from which they are named, that similars, for example, become similar because they partake of similarity, and that just and beautiful things become just and beautiful because they partake of justice and beauty," end quote. Then the form of manyness differs from that of oneness. I quote, "If a person shows that the same wood and stones and the like, being many, are also one," Socrates notices, "we admit that he shows the existence of the one and many, but he does not show that the many are one or the one many," end quote. To dismiss Socrates' claim, Parmenides, in his turn, attacks the notion of participation, trying to show that the theory of forms itself is not yet well established by its author. Parmenides is advancing three main arguments. The first one states that the forms can participate in the F-things as parts or wholes. Parmenides shows that both types of partaking are impossible. Therefore, the very notion of it should be doubted. Second, Parmenides notices that, for example, the abstraction of the form of greatness from the significant objects can be followed by another abstraction of greatness, which is, I quote, "over and above absolute greatness and the individuals which partake of it," and so on. "And there will be no longer a single idea of each kind, but an infinite number of them," end quote. Finally, Parmenides adds that different things are related to each other and not to the forms they partake of. On the other hand, the abstract forms themselves have nothing to do with real things, but with the abstract nature. Then he concludes, I quote, "None of the forms are known to us because we have no share in absolute knowledge," end quote. Before we examine Parmenides' first objection, let us make necessary remarks about the idea of separation. This vital notion is mentioned in the dialogue when Parmenides begins his discussion by asking whether that was Socrates's, I quote, "own distinction between abstract forms and the things which partake of them," end quote, and whether he thought that, I quote again, "there is an idea of likeness apart from the likeness which we possess," end quote. Here the separation, or distinction, being apart from, seems to have a meaning of the ontological priority of forms over particulars, stated by Socrates and Plato, as a sufficient condition for the existence of the former. The notion of separation also appears in Parmenides' argument against participation when he is trying to show that, I quote, "one and the same form, existing as a whole in many separate individuals, will thus be in a state of separation from itself," end quote. Both Socrates and his interlocutor agree on the negative side of the issue. If the form is separate from itself, then it is not equal or not identical to itself. Generally, if X is separate from Y, then X does not equal Y. Socrates rejects that kind of separation as perhaps a necessary condition for the existence of the forms. Now back to Parmenides' argument. Expressed in today's logical language, it could have taken the following form. Let P stand for participation is possible, and T for W is true or D is true, where W means the whole form itself is in many F things, and D that the distinct parts of the form are in many F things. Then if P is true, T is true. As Parmenides puts it, I quote, "does not in each individual partake either of the whole of the idea or of a part of the idea? Is any third way possible?" "Impossible," end quote, Socrates answered. At this point, one should consider two consequences of admitting those two possibilities, W and D. Let S stand for the form separate from itself, and O for the form having parts and remaining one at the same time. While keeping in mind that both statements are accepted as inconsistent in describing the reality of the forms. According to Parmenides, if one assumes that the whole form itself is in many F things, then such a form becomes separated from itself because of, I quote, "existing as a whole in many separate individuals," end quote. In other words, if W, then S. On the other hand, the assumption that the distinct parts of the form are in the many F things leads to another contradiction. In this case, Parmenides insists, I quote, "the ideas themselves will be divisible, and the individuals will have a part of them only, and not the whole existing in them," end quote, which is equal to say that, I quote again, "the one idea is really divisible and remains one," end quote. Using contemporary terminology, if D, then O. So the whole argument can be stated as follows. First premise, if P is true, T is true. Second premise, if W is true, then S. Third premise, if D is true, then O. The result, the conclusion, P is not valid. It might seem that in Parmenides, Plato dismisses his theory of forms by putting solid arguments against it in the mouth of Parmenides. The responses made by Socrates look weak, while in other dialogues they are definite and convincing. During the discussion, Socrates suggests that the forms could probably be, I quote, cognitions only and have no proper existence except in our minds, end quote. In other places, he proposes that, I quote again, they are patterns fixed in nature and that other things are like them and resemblances of them, end quote. Finally, he agrees with Parmenides that the difficulties should be overcome without knowing how. However, one can also see Parmenides as not answering the question of what participation is, but resolving the problem of what it is not. From this point of view, Plato came to some positive conclusions. He showed that the forms are not divisible or unknowable, and that the similarity between forms and things that participate in forms is not something third, separate, for example, another form, apart from them. This concludes my discussion of Plato's dialogue, Parmenides. In my presentation, I explain Parmenides' arguments against Socrates' theory of forms. I hope you enjoyed my video, and if you did, please do not forget to like it and subscribe to my channel. Remember, it's easy and free of charge. See you soon, stay safe and healthy, and goodbye.